And what they'll be seeing is ball in the hand of Keemo Paul. Quite skillful with the ball, changes of pace. Oh, pace on, and it's disappeared. That's the boundary for Judy K.
He peppers that offside, Quinton de Kock. That's an area of strength for him as a left-hand batter. Wasn't in the slot, he was driving on the up. He's had the chance to see a few deliveries off the surface, so adjusted, and adjusted well on that occasion.
Oh, that sounded good. And the result is the same. Twice as nice from Quinton de Kock.
Going past 200 runs in this edition of the Republic Bank CPL, Quinton de Kock. Once more leading the charge for the Royals with the bat. That's a brilliant shot. Just getting on top of the bounce, didn't try to go square. Slapped it virtually past the fielder in that mid-off position.
Yeah, a lot of conversations going on out there. Pressure on.
The Royals batting.
Oh, this goes up. And it goes over as well. Good runs for Athanase and the Royals. Republic Bank maximum. The end of 5, 48 for 1.
You felt for a moment there was a chance for Tim Robinson in that deep point position. Ball just had enough elevation to fly all the way for 6. Miss catch for cash opportunity, you can say.
He has nailed that, Jason Holder, using those long levers and that reach.
This is exactly what I'm talking about. You can't afford to risk pitching in the slot for Holder. That's his primary strength. That high back lift, just getting a stride in and allowing his long levers to strike the ball. I'd rather see Holder go square, maybe cut the ball or pull with pace off.
Important boundary, that first in 12 deliveries. Can that be the start for these next 9 deliveries of the innings? They need at least 3 or 4 sixes to get them to that 200 total. Current rate gets them to 184. That may not be enough with the Drew factor that we expect, just to keep getting more intense. Comes across his stumps this time and just over. Back-to-back sixes.
Brilliant striking from Holder. Barbados flags waving. They think they've conquered this Keemo Paul over. Already 15 with 2 legal deliveries left. Nice clean strike from Holder.
Surprised that he's gone away from that pace off option into the pitch. Last 2 have been full and have been 6. Picked up again. The power of Holder. 3 sixes.
Yeah, a bit of rebound here from Jason Holder. He would have had a tough night following that defeat inflicted by the Trinbago Knight Riders when he had to defend 11 runs in the last over. Things just didn't go right with the ball. Now making a splash with the bat, Holder.
And this was the risk Sheho always had when he bowled Pretorius the previous over, because it opened up Keemo Paul and maybe a Shamar Joseph from the other end for these Royals to attack. Last night, the last 2 overs, they got 28. They've already got 21 in the first 5 deliveries of this penultimate.
Just revisiting Holder's onslaught. sixes.
Right, enjoying things here in Barbados. We've enjoyed the action in the St. Lucia Darren Sammy Cricket Stadium. It's the last home game for the Kings. This could be a massive matchup. Maybe in the fight for 3 and 4 or 4 and 5. The Falcons taking on the Kings. The Falcons have picked up some good form. We're unlucky to miss out in that last game against the Royals due to the rain. And that will come at you live tomorrow night from 7 p.m. on air at 6:30. Final delivery of the over. Keemo Paul. Does he go back to pace off? Goes wide, and Jason Holder still is able to find the boundary. How crucial could this over be? 25 from the 19th, 187 for 4.
Well, there was no David Miller to close the innings out. In comes Jason Holder, didn't score with the bat in that last game against the Knight Riders. Now, a total contrast.